In today's video, I will tell you everything you wanted to know about machine learning on ASP32.
Everything?
Yes, absolutely everything. We're going to use both edge impulse train models and regular TensorFlow Lite for microcontrollers, and even output the results of object detection inference with bounding boxes as video stream in a web browser. The video is really condensed, so it's best if you watch from the beginning until the end. This way you don't miss anything. I'll be using Stick C+2, Siduino Xiao ASP32 S3, and Unit Camera OV2640. Links in the description. What I will be saying is more or less applicable to all of the ASP32 chips, although some of them are more suitable for machine learning than the others. We will run 4 different types of machine learning tasks: gesture recognition, keyword spotting, image recognition, and object detection. And a bonus one. I will focus strictly on running inference on the boards and give you the links to the resources for training the models. For gesture recognition, the task is to classify accelerometer data in one of a few movement categories. It doesn't have to be accelerometer data. Basically, any other sensor data, except for audio and images you might have, will fall into this category. Let's open an example project in Edge Impulse and go to the Deployment tab. Choose Arduino deployment. Unzip it and drop it into Arduino Libraries folder. Open the ASP32 Sensor Fusion example. There is a bunch of code here, but it all comes to a few important parts. There is a data acquisition, the inference, and the result output. The inference and the result output parts, they will not differ from board to board, but we need to modify the data acquisition code so it would use the accelerometer from STICC. Usually, you'd go to an example for your sensor and check how data is received. So here we go to examples, basic, IMU. All right. Then we'll be able to see how can we pull the accelerometer and how can we get the data necessary. Here I already modified the code. Specifically, you can see that init IMU function and pull IMU functions have been changed to use M5 Stick C accelerometer instead of the one that was used before. Okay, so let's hit compile and upload. You can see that I'm getting seemingly wrong but very confident results. This is because the accelerometer position is different on this board from the one where dataset was created. You can fix it by training your own model. For relatively slow sensors such as accelerometer, you can use the data forwarded tool to sample the data. I'm leaving the link to both documentation and video tutorial on how to do that. Audio data is trickier since it needs to be sampled with a frequency of at least 8 kHz. Or 8,000 times per second. Let's take another sample project for keyword spotting and download the Arduino library deployment. Open the microphone sketch, which is called microphone continuous in this case. Similar to what we did before, we need to modify the microphone data acquisition part. We have the init part here, the init part, and the capture samples. In this case, I'm not going to use one of the M5 stack libraries, but rather directly use I2S class from ESP IDEA. Here is a modified example. I only did a few modifications to the configuration. Also, I used a different I2S port number, which was changed in the init function, the init function, and also capture samples function here. Okay, run the inference and test. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, something, blah, 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 not really important. Hello, world.
Hello, world.
Now, the tricky part here is that when you need to sample the data with this word, you cannot use data forwarder. The UART data transfer rate is not fast enough for the audio data. We will need to modify the Edge Impulse ESP32 firmware for the board to support the microphone on Stixi, specifically the EIMicrophone.cpp. I have a branch in ESP32 firmware repository, which I made a while ago already, and let's take a look at the changes I made. They're very similar to the changes in Arduino Sketch. You can see that the config is modified, the I2S port is changed, both in init, deinit, and also the capture samples. That's actually pretty much it. After you apply similar modifications, depending on the board you use, simply compile it with ESP IDE 4.4 and upload. Then run Edge Impulse Daemon and sample the data. Easy peasy. For these two examples, we used Edge Impulse train models. If you are developing a project for personal or research use, there is no reason not to use Edge Impulse, as these are supported by free tier. However, if you want to know how to use TensorFlow Lite for microcontrollers, I got you covered as well. I want to preface it by saying that currently the official TensorFlow Lite micro library for Arduino is in a state of foobar. I spent hours fixing it and I got nowhere. But there is at least one maintained fork called Kirali TensorFlow Lite. So either git clone that or download zip and put it in your Arduino libraries folder. For the image recognition task, I created a sample Colab notebook where I train tiny, very tiny mobile net V1 model to distinguish between cats and dogs, the hello world of machine learning. In the end, after the training is done and the model is converted, you will get a model.h file. You can see that the model you have trained is in a binary format inside that file. Grab an Arduino sketch from GitHub repository for this video, and let's take a look at it. There is quite a bit more of the boilerplate code, including getting the model, then initializing the op resolver, the TensorFlow Lite interpreter, allocating the tensors. Then we also have to do the data quantization manually. In this case, actually, the data is already quantized, but we need to convert it from unsigned integer to signed integer. But the general idea is the same. We get the data from the camera, then we feed it into neural network here by copying the data from frame buffer to the output buffer. Then we run the inference with interpreter invoke, and then we simply read the results. In this case, we also dequantize them to get the scores for the two classes. Finally, for the object detection task, we are going to use Shiduino Xiao ESP32S3, which is based on ESP32S3, with vector extensions for accelerated neural network inference. Download the Arduino library. And open the camera web server example for ESP32, which I heavily modified to work with any of the Edge Impulse models, and Xiao ESP32S3. The modifications are too many to explain here, but if you're interested, you can use the compare files function in your favorite IDE. Most of the modifications were done to the app.httpd.cpp file. Upload the sketch, let the board connect to Wi-Fi, and then go to the displayed web address. Start the stream and enable the face detection. Neat. Okay, so with so much talk about large language models, someone would inevitably ask, can I run an LLM on ESP32? The answer is yes, you can, but it won't be very useful. Using the code by Dave Ben, I ran an extremely tiny version of Llama on ESP32S3, which outputs semi-coherent text generating children's stories as it is trained on Tiny Stories dataset, as you can see here. For me to successfully run it, I had to fix the code a little bit, so also you can see the example in the GitHub repository. Take a look at how I was teaching my toaster to talk by training and running extremely small language model on Raspberry Pi. Or watch a video about running a bit larger but much more capable Tiny Lemma on Raspberry Pi as well. It is both coherent and fast.